This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back. You take the blue pill, the story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill, you stay in Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes. Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
You have a better resume. Do you believe you have a better resume than Deontay Wilder?
Come on, Tyson, be real.
I'm always real. I'm always real. Always. And that's a fantastic question, and it depends on which angle you're coming from. You're looking at a man here who's knocked out 43 opponents in a row. Now, even if I hate this guy, I've got to respect that. That is awesome. I never met anybody before who knocked out everybody they ever fought.
My buddy from play school.
I've got nothing. I can't take anything from him. He's a great puncher. He gets the job done. People say, oh, he can't box, but you know, I wouldn't mind being a shit boxer if I could win 43 in a row.
Yo, you making me mad. You really making me mad, Fury. Now, you know this bum-ass, doodle-faced, skid-mark-ass dude done picked everybody he fought out of the Campbell's catalog of tomato cans. Come on, fam. So, you gonna sit up here and lie and try to say this man is a good boxer when you know he done picked all of his fighters out of the Campbell's soup catalog? Come on, fam. So that's what we doing now, Fury? You making me mad. You really making me mad. The nerve of this nigga.
Oh, I don't know. Yeah. So, and I'm on my thing. I've beat some guys as well. I beat obviously a light weight champion, Klitschko. Some people say it wasn't the most exciting fight, but at the end of the day, it was about winning and getting victory for me. That's all that mattered, was victory on these big occasions. And I beat a few other contenders along the way as well, 29 of them to be precise. I've won 6 belts as well. So yeah, this is why it's an eagerly anticipated fight and people want to see who's the best. And I do as a boxing fan, and so does Deontay. I know he does. And this is why we're throwing down. This is why I respect this man, because in a lot of other weight divisions, especially in our era, we're the only 2 undefeated warriors. We turned pro at the same time. We're still undefeated at the same time. And we're going to put it all on the line yet again for the fans.
You're making me mad, Baldy. You really making me mad, Baldy. You up here, y'all up here stroking each other nuts like shake weights. I repeat, y'all up here stroking each other egos like shake weights up this jump.
Ladies, when you put on that sleeveless dress, what's the first thing that sticks out? Our arms are the problem area that we never seem to be able to find the solution for until now with the shake weight. Shake Weight is the flab-busting breakthrough that trims your arms and shapes your shoulders at the same time.
The back of my arm, definitely in the tricep area.
Oh my gosh, I can feel the definition already.
That's a real workout.
You just shake it, back and forth. There's no motor, no batteries, and you get the results you want.
In a matter of seconds, you feel it really working your muscles. My arms feel worked. It's definitely a good workout. I'm feeling it in my chest and my biceps and my triceps.
Tossing that joint back and forth, just stroking away. Stroke. Gonna lead to a little hokey pokey after the presser. Ooh. The real press conference going down after this. You making me mad. You really making me mad right now. Y'all got some nerve. Y'all are not the 2 top heavyweights in the world. I know Anthony Joshua over that joint like, look at these 2 clown ass shake weight playing.
Back of my arm. Definitely in the tricep area.
Oh my gosh, I can feel the definition already.
That's a real workout.
Booty deuce spraying ass niggas. You making me mad. You really making me mad, bro.
So I look at it, when I look at things and I see my opponents and how they try to prepare for me, you know, I look at it in two ways. You know what I mean? I'm always optimistic. I'm an optimistic person anyway. You know, I don't look and say, well, I'm untouchable and you know, I'll never be able to do this and do that, or they're gonna do this to me. You know, I look on both sides of the field, but you know, that warrior in me, the mentality that I have, that king spirit, you know, I fight with the ancestors. And, you know, with that being said, it's gonna take a lot more than just me to be able to be with God.
You fight with the ancestors, but you just said you don't feel as though, you know, you're untouchable, that you can't be beat. Any other time, you know, you don't speak like that, so you're not speaking with the same confidence. So I think that Fury's living in your head a little bit. You seem a little bit concerned over there, doo-doo. You seem a little bit concerned over there, doo-doo, which you should be. Rightfully, you should be, because you know you didn't win that fight last time. You truly know you didn't win that fight last time. So let me show you. Exhibit A. See, you can say all of the things you want, Deontay, but the eyes never lie.
The eyes, Chico, they never lie.
The eyes are the windows to the soul. And in this picture right here, after that 12-round bell rung, you could clearly tell that you lost. You didn't even raise your hands up after the fight. You went back to your corner with your head down, trying to hug JD's, and he had to remind you to put your hands up and to pretend or act confident like you won anyway. And then the judge gave you a draw.
How would it feel to deliver Deontay Wilder's first loss?
You know, I've beaten quite a few undefeated fighters in my time.
Does this one have a little more weight on it?
To be fair, whether they're undefeated or they're not, whoever is considered a good man at that time, whether he's got losses on his record or he hasn't, the victory is the victory. I'd take it anyway.
I'm sure you feel the same way.
Yeah, I'm sure every professional athlete feels the same way, for sure.
Well, for me, you know, it's, I think with him, it's going to be, every fight, every victory, I've knocked it off a few undefeated fighters myself. But I think this is going to be a little bit more special for me.
Why?
It's just because of the history that we have, the controversial draw, and, you know, for me, I consider Tyson like a breath of fresh air for me, especially in the heavyweight division, you know, because a lot of the other guys just still, they don't want to open their mouth. They don't want to really just let themselves loose and have fun. And already it's such a dangerous sport.
Now you see now, you done fucked up, you know that, don't you?
I see what I'm saying.
I thought...
You know what I'm saying? You done fucked up now, you know that, don't you?
Fight fans, I challenge you to read between the lines of what Deontay Wilder was saying, because he was blending the truth with a whole lot of lies. Now I'll go ahead and get into that. Do you see how Tyson Fury answered the question? He just said it's another notch under his record. He's beat plenty of undefeated fighters before and others that are way more accomplished than him. Though he didn't want to say that, because we already know this press conference is a Fox ego stroke for Deontay Wilder. Now Deontay Wilder said it was special to him, for him, because you know a lot of fighters don't talk in such a dangerous sport. And Fury is a breath of fresh air for him because he speaks. Well, if that was the case, why do you guys have the muzzle on him in both press conferences? And why didn't you want to have press conference in the beginning? Huh? You have him in a controlled environment. It has nothing to do with that at all.
No, sir.
It has to do with the fact that Deontay Wilder is fully aware of what people say about him. Deontay Wilder is fully aware of his lackluster record. Deontay Wilder is fully aware of what people say about his technical abilities. And Deontay Wilder is fully aware that people think he's a coward and he's not willing to fight anyone. He sees what everybody says on new media. Deontay Wilder needs the Tyson Fury win under his record. He needs the scalp on his mantle so he can say, hey, I beat a lineal unified heavyweight, former unified heavyweight champion of the world, and Tyson Fury. So that's something nobody can take away from him. Deontay Wilder desperately needs a credible scalp.
Yeah.
So that is why this fight is very special to him, because he knows for a fact that he has been crushing cans of tomatoes, of Campbell's tomato soup his whole fucking career.
Boom.
Actually, working on power and again, if so, what are you doing to sort of get more power behind your punches?
Well, to answer your question, would it be walking into his hands? Well, it would be if I was to go put my chin right in front of him. It's like, look, Deontay, knock me out, please. What on the hard they're gonna do? You know, the thing is, how do you beat the massive puncher? You've got to back him up. You have to back him up, because he gets massive leverage in those long arms, coming forward and landing those big punches. So I gotta back him up, put him on the back foot.
And see, fight fans, that's what I've been saying the whole time leading up to this. That's exactly what I knew. That's exactly what Fury meant. Fury's gonna press the attack. He's gonna use his weight as an advantage. He's gonna wait for Deontay Wilder to swing one of them flailing rights. He's gonna slip inside, and then he's going to press him. He's gonna press him against those ropes. He's gonna lean that 6'10 weight all over him. He's gonna bang out his body. He's gonna chop him downstairs, and he's gonna come upstairs with chopping right and left hooks. And he's gonna touch him on his chin, and his plan is to knock him out. We all know that Deontay Wilder doesn't have any technique, and he's very fearful of the things that Tyson Fury can do. Because as we all know, Deontay Wilder is a one-trick pony. Deontay Wilder doesn't have a plan B. All Deontay Wilder is hoping to land that right hand and knock Fury out. But when that fails, what else can you do? Tyson Fury he's a multifaceted fighter with a bunch of different options. But we all know that Deontay Wilder has never been pressed by an elite fighter. And when it comes February 22nd, that's what's gonna happen. And his chin is gonna be very susceptible to being knocked out, because we all know that Deontay Wilder has no defense or technical ability, and he definitely, definitely cannot fight off the back foot. What's up, fight fans? It's your man 3K the Boss, AKA Mr. Two Hands Up. You know what it is. Man, I apologize that you guys had to sit through that cringy-ass ego stroke. Well, believe it or not, I chopped it down a lot, and I just got to the strong points, you know, in the presser. And, you know, there were a few strong points in there, but, you know, you got to read between the lines to be able to think in layers to see what was going on, because there was a lot said. But luckily, you got me two hands to break it down for you. But besides all of that, since we already took it there and I explained that, man, Tyson Fury disgusted me with this whole ego stroke. Stroking this man ego about his record. Stroking this man ego about his temperament. Stroking this man ego. It was just absolutely disgusting, cringeworthy, and it just made me want to go blah all over my fresh ass outfit. You know what I mean? But hey, it is what it is, man. I took the strong points that I could take from it. But all in all, man, it was just another Fox press, an ego stroke. I almost wish they wouldn't have had no press conferences, you know, if it was going to be like this. No, but there were very telling things involved, and I broke that shit down for you guys the best way I could. You know that they got to stroke little Shelly Tinkles, you know what I mean? Very brittle mind state to make sure he's the best that he can going into this fight. But as Tyson Fury said in the first presser, if you guys didn't miss it, he said that he doesn't want to beat up on Deontay Wilder in these press conferences, because everybody will say that, you know, he was mentally weak, living rent-free in his head, so he wants to build him up, make him feel like he's the best fighter in the world, so when he goes in the ring and knocks him out, there can be no dispute. And then he really breaks him apart, and he really caves in. Because I know Tyson Fury wants to peel his whole scalp back. Yeah. But that shit was not the art of war. That was more like the art of fucking peace. And it was absolutely cringeworthy. And I'm sorry, you, me, and the rest of the fucking fans had to sit through that fucking bullshit. But you know Deontay Wilder fans absolutely loved it. And I'm going to tell you why they absolutely loved it. Because just like, you know what I mean, Deontay Wilder's little weak ass, his fans are emotional and weak just like him. And of course they're gonna say, oh man, those guys, they conducted themselves, you know, like true champions are supposed to. I have a lot of respect for those guys, blah, because they're weak. Just like the fucking weak ass comments that they leave on my page 24/7 when I did the dog his bitch ass. But that's all I got for you guys, man. It's time to tune in to Quiet Storm Radio on 69.6. Let's get it. Yo, it's your man 3K the Boss, aka Mr. Two Hands Up. You know what it is, and you tuning in to Two Hands Quiet Storm Radio. We gotta take this time to do it for the soft. We gotta take this time to do it for the weak. We gotta take this time to do it for the bitches, and especially the bitch ass niggas. I'm talking about Tyson Fury, the Gypsy Queen. I'm talking about Deontay Wilder. So let's go ahead and slow this thing down the way we used to. I'm talking about that 90s baby shit. Yeah. Y'all know what I'm talking about. That quiet storm. Let's get it. Look at him. Yeah. Look at him. I'd rather not. The caress is ever so real.
You know it.
Look at him.
Disgusting.
The touch of love. Look at him. Oh, yeah. It's going down tonight.
What they about to do?
Uh-huh. It's going down tonight.
Let's get it.
Touch me, Fury. Touch me, she. Touch me, Fury.
Like that.
Touch me, she.
Like that. Oh.
Like that. Doo-doo. Gotta do it for the doo-doo. Oh, yeah. You the king.
Been crowned. Ah.
Yeah. My gypsy king. That's how you feel, Shiante.
The royal penis is clean, your
highness. That's how you feel, Shiante.
The royal penis is clean, yeah. Your highness.
Niggas are getting body to body.
Pass me the shake weight.
This the real press conference right here.
Pause.
Yeah. This the real press conference right here. Y'all go ahead and let that quiet storm smooth that thing out for y'all. Somebody getting pregnant tonight. Shiante getting pregnant tonight.
Oh God.
It's none other than your DJ, 3K the Boss, always head bust on your favorite radio station. 90, 69. Let that thing smooth out and let's ride. 69.9. We're all the bitch boys. Backdoor slide. I'm pregnant, Fury. Let that thing smooth out for you. It's the real press conference. It's the real press conference, doo-doo.
Sheesh.
It's the real press conference, Gypsy Queen.
Like that.
Yeah. And as we always say, at the end of this shit,
what's
it
that?
Costs you nothing to pay a nigga no mind. It's the motherfucking boss. You get no respect though. It's the quiet storm, nigga. Yo. And as always, you can follow the homie Two Hands on Twitter at M2HandsUp. No spaces. Respect, though.